Hi, my name's Tamsin from the English Garden magazine. It's autumn and I'm cutting back the borders here now because I'm really keen to put some bulbs in, and it's almost impossible to plant bulbs with all the dead foliage around. By cutting back now, you can get organised for spring. So you don't have to do it, you can leave it until spring so you can enjoy the seed heads throughout the winter. It's entirely up to you. But the most important thing is, when you are cutting back the border, is to do it properly. People get a bit nervous about cutting things back, so I'm going to demonstrate to you quite how brutal you can be. My main tool is shears. If you use just secateurs, it will take you an awfully long time. So I can quickly cut through quite large chunks of plants. And then the secateurs are very, very useful when you've got thicker stemmed plants, because you want to cut them right back to the ground, hardy perennials. Don't leave little stumps off, because they'll just end up as little dead stumps in your border. So I'm going to show you how hard you can cut back. So this Echinops here, this is probably a better plant to cut back with the secateurs. Get right down to the base of the plant. Cut the stems and pull them out as low as you can go. Sometimes easy to take the tops off first so you can see what you're doing. And all this can be shredded and put on the compost heap. So get right down to the bottom, and you can sometimes pull the leaves out, some of the leaves. Plants like Alströmeria actually benefit from the stems being pulled out rather than cut back. It gives them stronger growth the following year. So I'm going right down to the stump of the plant. And then what I'll do is I'll get my small rake once I've cut all this back, and I'll rake any dead leaves out of the crown of the plant. So just use a little rake like this, and you can get right in and take the dead leaves off. So you've got to go through the border and clearing really carefully. Now, the biggest challenge when cutting back any border is dealing with clematis correctly. We grow a lot in the border and they look spectacular running through the perennials in summer. There are three different types of clematis. They're put into three different pruning groups. Group one are the early flowering clematis in the spring, such as Montana. They don't actually need pruning at all, unless you want to tidy them up, and you do that in late winter. Cut them back too hard and you might miss out on flowers because they flower on old wood. Group two, such as this here, President, is the variety of this group two clematis. They flower early summer. Now, they flower on the previous year's wood, so I mustn't cut this back to the ground or I will miss out on flowers. So I'm literally going to take it to about here and carefully pull the top part out of the shrub. Group three are the late flowers, such as Tangutica. They flower on new wood, so you can hack them right back to the ground. The difficulty is if you don't know what type of clematis you've got, so keep your labels to avoid missing out on flowers. So I'm literally going to cut these top stems like this. You can cut them almost anywhere, and then pull that material out of the top of this plant. What I don't want to do is pull them from the base. So it's a bit like dealing with spaghetti. You've just got to be really careful that you don't cut the wrong stem and pull it out from the base. So here we are. It takes time. Okay, so another job that's really key at this time of year is removing dead, diseased or damaged wood from your shrubs. So ideally I would have cut back all this so I can see my shrubs, but I've got a berberis at the back that needs some urgent attention. Right, so this berberis has seen better days. There's a lot of woody material here that's actually completely dead. You can see that's even just falling away. There's no point in leaving these dead stems over winter. It will encourage pests, disease. So get yourself a nice sharp saw, secateurs, remove all the dead wood, and you can see it's dead. There's no life in that whatsoever. If unsure, scratch the stem with your finger and see if there's any greenery. But I mean, this almost needs removing. It's seen better days. I'm going to give it one more year and cut out all the dead growth and see what happens. So I'm going to go right down to the base. These are completely dead. you might need a saw for this, but this shrub has definitely seen better days. So there we are, no life in that whatsoever. So it's a good time of year to assess your shrubs and a great time to plant new ones. Right, I've got to crack on and cut all this back and then run a rake over it.